HCS New Orleans 2018 recap and some insider MCC updates that I think everyone will enjoy. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another news update video in Halo. If you enjoyed this kind of news update videos, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this, and we'll get right into the video here. So in case you didn't know, the new season for Halo competitive HCS season just started up this weekend with the New Orleans event. Now, of course, this being an HCS event, it had its moments of highlights with some really close games, especially between Splice and Elevate. There was the one Stronghold game that had an epic comeback. You have to go check it out. I'll leave a link in the description down below to the video, as well as a Splice and Tox had just the most intense clutch plays, constant clutch plays happening in this one team Slayer match. Leave that in the link in the description down below. These links will be taking you to Devious Grunt Alliance's YouTube page. This guy does a great job of giving you some of the highlights that most people are not able to catch, because he watches like all of it and is able to capture all the good moments. So I highly suggest you go check out his channel. Give him a sub, tell him Kevin sent you over there. But yeah, some great videos that he captured that you definitely want to check out. Now, during this HCS event, there was a situation that I almost broke out into a fight, really, between Ryan Noob and Spartan. If you guys don't know, they were kind of beefing a bit on Twitter before this event. And, you know, that's kind of whatever. But then, actually what happened was that Trifecta, the team that Ryan Noob was on, did end up beating Elevate, which the team that Spartan was on. And as soon as the game was over and, you know, the match was won, Ryan Noob walked right over into the face of Spartan and just started talking trash right at him. So the point was really more conflicting and trying to be more combative, almost, it feels like. And, you know, obviously there's levels of, you know, S talking, or, you know, talking trash to people, you want to call it or whatever. But it's something that's just, it just seems rather disrespectful to do that. And I'd really hate to see that kind of stuff happen. Like, you don't want to see fights happen on a stage after a game is played, because it just doesn't look good for the event as a whole. And so I really didn't like how Ryan Noob went about doing that. I mean, you can gloat, you can kind of pound your chest in front of the guy or whatever, but don't get in their face and try to start a fight. It just ruins the sport of the game. It's just bad sportsmanship, really. And that's really what I want to say about that. But here is the final brackets of how the entire event played out. Some upsets and some surprising outcomes. So the winning team of the event was Splice. No surprise there. Though it was rather surprising, because they were seeded in 9th place from the 2K rankings online matches. But I think it due to mainly Splice not really practicing much before the main event, but somehow they're able to pull it off and win again. And so they won this event. Number 2 went to Tox, 3 went to Renegades, which was actually rather surprising, 4 went to Trifecta, which this was the biggest upset here. I was not expecting Trifecta to finish in the top 4. Reciprocity and Hitman finished for 5th and 6th, and then Elevate and Berserker tied for 7th and 8th place as well. Reciprocity, which to me was probably the biggest letdown when it came to placements. I was really expecting them to, you know, possibly make a run for the number 1 seed for this event. Well, they were the number 1 seed for this event, but win the event itself. But just some things just didn't work out in their favor. Also, this event, the finals was finally announced for the HCS season. Now, it will take place in Atlanta on November 16th through the 18th. During DreamHack Atlanta as well. So a nice little combination there of some Halo and some DreamHack, a big gaming event right there. So definitely want to check that out. So if you guys have a chance, go check it out. I highly suggest it. I went to the finals in April and it was a blast. I had such a great time. One, getting to watch just high level Halo. Two, just being in the event and having just like the hype of just, you know, everyone being equally as excited for Halo as much as I am, watching some high tier gameplay. It's just really fun. And plus, 3, I got that chance, actually had a chance to meet up with some YouTube people, some Twitch people. Even a subscriber said they saw me at the event as well. So it's kind of cool. So if you guys ever have a chance to go to these events, I highly suggest you go do that. And one thing kind of surprised me is that at this World Finals event, there's going to be a $10,000 Halo 3 MCC 2v2 tournament happening that same weekend. So apparently 343 is feeling so confident about the stable state of the MCC is that they're gonna put some competition back into it. So it'll be cool to see some Halo 3 brought back into some MLG gameplay. So with this announcement that there's going to be a Halo 3 MCC 2v2 tournament happening at this Atlanta Finals, this pretty much confirms to you that there will be the MCC update patch that will pretty much fix the multiplayer of this game will be released before November 16th. It has to happen for this event to even function properly. So you can kind of get a better scope of idea of when this MCC update will come out. There's no definitive date when it will be announced, though Sketch did say on 343 forums that the MCC update will come out once the MCC goes to the Xbox Game Pass, so which will apparently happen before November 16th, so there would be a functioning version of the MCC for people to play. Now that we're talking about the MCC, it's a nice little segue here into the recent update that had come around for the MCC Insider build 1.462, which brings two features and a bug that was popularly reported by you the players. One of the big features I am genuinely excited about this is a main menu volume slider. That is right, you can actually turn down the volume of the music in MCC, which if you don't know, that music blares every time, and especially if you're a streamer like me, that music really will conflict with the music that you have on stream, or if you're making any kind of videos or anything like that. So it's really nice to be able to turn that stuff off. Especially, I mean, the music is great, don't get me wrong, I love the music, it sounds fantastic. It's just that when you hear it for like the 800th time in a row, you're like, okay, I think I've heard this song enough, you know? The other feature that we're adding in is the network ping to matchmaking servers. So basically they're gonna let you know what your ping is to the server, which is gonna be absolutely fantastic. It's so great to know what your connection is to the server. So it lets you know how aggressive you really can play and what you can really get away with. Because if you have a high ping, you're probably gonna wanna stay back and play a little bit more defensive. But if you have a very low ping, you can be really aggressive and you'll play like a pro basically. So I think I'd like to add in this next portion of the video here, just replying to your guys' comments in the last video. I think it'd be a great way to help interact with your guys in these videos here, and also just kind of give a full-on opinion that might not be able to be conveyed so well during text. My last video talking about the community Slayer update video, Random Elite said, "Please make this a permanent playlist. Hopefully 343 sees the positivity and keeps it up." I 100% agree with this. I think that the Community Slayer playlist should just be a permanent playlist where you're just constantly rotating new Forge maps. Because I think, one of them, if people want to have fresh, brand new content or new maps to play on, that's the place you can go and do that. Because I think right now all the ranked set maps are pretty much set in stone, really, pretty much right now. I don't see much changing until Halo Infinite comes around. And then I think that it also will help improve the forging community as well, like maybe motivate more people to, like, hey, this is more likely than ever the map that you create can get put in the matchmaking. Because I think if you're a forger, at least for making like 4v4 maps, that would be like a pinnacle thing for you to have happen, right? For everyone just jumps in the matchmaking and plays your map, that would be pretty exciting, at least for me. So I would love to see this be a permanent place where you're just rotating new maps constantly, like every 2 weeks or something like that. I think it'd be a fantastic addition. Another comment here from Leroy Thompson says, "Buying a new game today, which is better or more populated online, Halo 5 or the Master Chief Collection?" Definitely Halo 5 is much more populated right now, though I could see a population surge due to the update that will probably be coming out this fall once MCC goes to Game Pass. Though, if you want, based on population, probably Halo 5. And honestly, you probably want to play Halo 5 as it might be the direction 343 is going for the next Halo Infinite game. And so, definitely want to go with Halo 5, I would say. Andrew878D says, "We really need a BTB map refresh. IMO, more than another temporary arena playlist. A lot of people are turned off from BTB because it's become so stale for so long." I 100% agree with this as well, that we need some new maps for BTB because it's been such a long time since we've had a refresh or some kind of update with the Forge maps for BTB. There are plenty of great Forge maps out there, and I really would like to see them integrated into the playlist as well. Ionix Gaming says, "They should add this playlist to Halo Infinite. I would totally like to actually see that happen. Have there be like a social Slayer playlist, a core play, and then also a community Slayer playlist. I think that would be rather awesome. They help constantly keep people motivated to making more Forge maps. I think this is just a fantastic playlist. I would love to see stay within Halo 5 and also in Halo Infinite as well. You should get a way to showcase the community's efforts of, you know, putting time into your game and, being very appreciative of that as well. Anyways, guys, that's the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. If you want to see some more content from me, make sure to tap that subscribe button with the notifications. Let you know every time I upload anything awesome to this channel, which is going to be every time. Let me know what you think about the updates in this video. I do read all the comments and try to reply to most of them as well. And you might even get featured in the next video as well. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.